So I'm sat in the BMW M5 CS, which is an accelerating BMW road car you can buy. And next to me is the quickest BMW vehicle you can buy, their new M motorcycle. And we're gonna have a drag race. Let me tell you about this car first of all. So it's got a 4.4 litre twin turbo V8 that puts out 635 horsepower and 750 newton meters of torque. It drives all four wheels on 8-speed torque converter automatic gearbox with launch control. It weighs in at 1,825 kilos and costs £140,000. Now to find out about the bike, I'm gonna go over to Chris Northover from Bike World TV, because I know nothing about bikes.
So Chris, tell me about your bike.
What's the engine capacity? What's the horsepower? How much does it cost? All that lovely stuff.
It's blue and white. Pretty, isn't it? Now this is a BMW M1000RR. So it's 212 horsepower, 192 kilo bike. It's kind of the pinnacle of BMW's high performance motorcycles. Costs £35,000, which is cheaper than your car, but a lot for a bike. But it is an exquisite work of art. And it has wings.
Yeah, you've got carbon fiber on your bike. Not many bikes have carbon fiber. Lots of cars do these days, but not many bikes.
No, definitely not in the amount of carbon fiber that's on this. It is, even the wheels are carbon fiber. How about that?
Wow. That's how they can justify the like 35 grand price tag, right?
Absolutely. And this is rather than just sort of a bolt-on special version of the S1000RR. This does have an upgraded engine, upgraded chassis, frame, yoke, so it's a pretty comprehensive upgrade, and it looks cool as.
It's a bit like with this car, actually, because it's a significant upgrade over the normal M5 competition. Like, you've got carbon fibre bonnet, you get these carbon fibre seats as standard, you get sport seats in the back as well, and there's loads of weight removed from this car over the standard M5. It's a good chunk. I can't remember off the top of my head, so we're going to put it up on screen now. Anyhow, if you like these kind of drag race videos, make sure... Now, before we race, we're going to do the customary car wow sound check. Okay, so I'm going to rev up this BMW, see what it sounds like. Here we go. That bike's going to sound better, isn't it? We've got a soft limiter at 4,500 RPM. Go on, Chris, rev up the bike. Was that your launch control engaging there?
Yeah, this has a rev cut at 9,000 RPM for launch control.
Will you use launch control in the race, or are you going to just try and do it yourself?
I don't want to sound like a Luddite here, but at the moment, I'm still slightly quicker than the launch control, so I'm going to know it's there, acknowledge it's there, and not bother with it.
I'm totally not quicker than the car's launch control, so I'm going to rely on it 100%. Now, before we actually do the race, we need to warm up our tyres, so I'm going to warm mine up first, okay? There we go. Chris, let's see what you got.
I enjoyed that. That was brilliant.
A lot of smoke. I'm finished with a little stoppy.
I think mine are warm as well now.
I think you weren't that. That was brilliant. I was really smug, me drifting around you, then like stopping dead on where I've got to start from. Whereas you did a perfect circle, and then I was like, what's he doing just riding around me? Then I noticed you had your knee down. That was skills. I love that. And we will help you change your car. And now we are actually finally going to race. Let's do this. Best off the line there, cock that up a bit and he's gonna get me. Ah.
That was neck and neck for a long time there, wasn't it?
I know. I mean, I don't want to like play things down a bit by saying that my launch wasn't great and I was a bit slow off the line or anything like that. And it's not me just trying to get another go. Can I have another go?
You always give me another go, so definitely.
I had him off the line that time. Coming now though, and he's wheeling. Oh, the bugger!
You were very sharp off the line there, Matt.
Does that mean you think I cheated?
No, I'm not saying it. I've fallen for that one before.
Well, let's find out. Stewards, can you tell me if I jumped the start?
There was no jump at the start. No
well,
jump.
There we are.
You were very wise not to say that I jumped it by saying sharp. You kept it ambiguous, so I didn't. I did a perfect launch. This car isn't really going to do any better than that. How was your launch on the bike?
Not as good as the first one, I've got to admit, but still pulled it back by the quarter, so.
Yeah, that was cool. There's no point doing it again. The bike won, even though this launched as good as it's ever going to.
However, you've got four big comfy seats in there. That is phenomenal for a family saloon.
It's nuts. This thing is just absolutely brilliant. But if you want to go fast, for less money, get a bike. So then what exactly happened? Well, the Superbike won, completing the standing quarter mile in 10.3 seconds. The M5 CS took 11 seconds. Okay, now we're going to have a rolling race from 50 miles an hour. Both vehicles in third gear. Okay, there's 50. 3, 2, 1, go. I've got no chance of I'm just going to get absolutely dicked on. It is wheeling just for the lols. Cheeky bugger. First of the half mile. Is he even braked early? Taking the piss. You were just mocking me there, weren't you?
I did wonder where you'd gone.
You were wheeling and then you actually backed out of it well before.
I didn't want to make it look too silly.
Oh, do you know what? Give me a chance, right? Let's try that again, but this time you start in fourth gear. I'm going to stay in third, all right?
Okay.
You do know where the half mile is, don't you?
I do, yeah.
You're just taking the piss.
I just wonder where you were.
Cheeky bugger. I thought he'd done what Danny Petrosa did when I was racing him. If you want to see what I'm talking about, it's a brilliant drag race with that famous MotoGP rider. Click on the pop-out banner up there for the link in the description below to go check out that video. It is awesome. Let's see if this helps me out. Now he's in fourth gear. Let's find out. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, go. Ah, it's a bit better. Oh, here he goes now. Okay.
Closer.
Yeah. So, and you didn't back off either.
I didn't.
You didn't do any cheeky wheelies.
I didn't. I had less mocking that time, I'll give you that.
Right then. Still won though, by a sizeable margin. So, this time you're going to have to do it in fifth gear.
Fifth?
Yeah, come on.
I don't know if it'll pull.
It will. So, he's in fifth. I'm in third. 3, 2, 1, go. Come on! Can't do anything. I bet you know what I'm going to say next.
Third.
No. You know it.
Sixth gear, really?
Sixth gear, top gear, right?
Okay.
Come on. 3, 2, 1, go. Come on, car. Oh, yes, we might have him this time. Pulling me back in. Come on, car, come on.
Oh, on the line. I was actually rooting for you that time.
Don't take the piss. I wasn't rooting for you. I thought I was going to have you, but just...
Bike length, if that.
That bike is so fast. Pulling like that. In top gear?
Yeah.
Nuts.
Phenomenal.
Anyway, let's move on to a challenge where I have the advantage. Now we're going to do a brake test from 100 miles an hour. We're going to reach line, full emergency stop. Which vehicle will stop in the shortest distance? Or how difficult will it be for Chris to stay on his bike? If you're watching the drag race with him on a bike, click on the pop-out banner up there for the link in the description below. If not, stay here because here comes the line. Oh, and a little stoppy to end with. He lost that quite badly.
Absolutely toasted me.
I'm going to go around one more time, only because I actually won something. Yay!
It wasn't even close.
Bit like the rolling races. To be fair. You still did a good job though, and I like the stoppie at the end. This almost felt like it was doing a stop when I was brake testing it.
I can't believe how quick that stopped.
I know. Massive brakes, massive tyres. Really, really, really impressive.
So this can get into trouble quicker, and that can get out of it faster.
Yeah, but if you bin this, it costs a lot more than that.
To be fair.
Although you might be in a slightly worse state than I might be. Although you do have the option of jumping off that.
I can. I don't think any of it bears thinking about.
No, it doesn't anyway. If you want to see Chris do some more crazy stuff on bikes, then click on the pop-out banner or follow the link in the description below to go check out Bike World TV. Anyway, I hope you all enjoyed the video. If you did, give it a like. Click on those windows there, somewhere over Chris, to watch more videos. And if you click on that box there, there's a little surprise for you. Thanks for watching.